Yep. We're here with my beloved. She says she wants to make me a slab of meat. And I tell her I already have one. But. Sorry, my love.
Hello, darling.
How are you, my love?
I'm wonderful. How are you?
What do you got?
So, we went to the International Meat Market in Astoria this week and spoke with the owner.
Yanni.
Exactly.
Good guy.
And he brought out a huge, huge rack of ribs for standing prime rib roast. So I thought, we haven't had this for a long time. So he started preparing it, which means cutting it off the rack. I said, I would like a 2-rib roast. He started to trim in between here and asked me.
Where?
In between the ribs.
Yeah.
And I mentioned about Frenching, and he looked up very, very happy and said, would you like me to French that for you? And I said, I would love that.
Is Frenching hard to do?
It takes some absolute degree of skill to French a piece of meat this expensive well. So he trimmed in between the bones, he trimmed underneath, he took out unnecessary fat, but we still have in the meat itself some beautiful marbling, which is what we want for flavor.
What is marbling?
Marbling are the little pieces of fat that run through the beef. Some people love it loaded with fat, and I think it's fatty enough.
That's extra marbling, right?
Extra marbling means extra fat. This is just...
extra fat.
This is just enough fat. So I have had this sitting out at room temperature for about 4 hours.
Okay.
Yanni also tied it for me. He scored it so that all of this...
looks beautiful.
He did a gorgeous job. That's,
well, you mentioned 37 years. I didn't even know that.
I think 37 years is a very nice level of experience to be able to work with beef and every other product they carry. They carry some of the most beautiful lamb chops I've ever seen. Now I'm taking about a full tablespoon of Herbes de Provence.
Herbes de Provence.
So we have thyme in here, we have rosemary.
Now, why don't you just throw them in there?
So I'm rubbing it between my hands to release the oils.
Really?
Yeah, because they're dried herbs, and so by putting a little bit of body warmth on these.
I remember the first time you told me that, I was like, wow.
A little body
with
heat.
Red pepper flakes, you were squeezing them, and I was like, just throw them. Like, no. I could taste the difference.
So I'm mixing these, the Herbes de Provence with soft butter, about one stick of butter for a 2-rib. Now I'm going to take that, because we're getting ready to roast this, and I'm going to cover this, because this is going to keep it moist, flavorful. It's going to help to seal in the juices. And I'm going to be preparing this in what's called a closed oven door method.
Where's the oven?
So the
oven and you have a door, so it's closed.
So this is going to
be... are there open door ovens?
So what?
I think they are. The brick ovens.
What that means is that I'm going to cook this 5 minutes per pound. This is about a 4-pounder. 20 minutes at 500 degrees, so it's going to go into an extremely, exceptionally, super hot oven. 20 minutes, and I am not going to touch it at all after I turn the oven off after 20 minutes. I am not opening the oven door. I am leaving it alone. There's not going to be any basting. There's not going to be any looking, touching.
How about cooking on top?
None of it.
Wow.
So we're going to...
is that why you're having me leave the house?
No, my love. So this is going to go in very shortly. It's going to then stay in a closed door oven, sealed, for the next 2 hours.
Are you going to wrap it with anything?
No. I'm encasing it in this beautiful Herbes de Provence mix with the butter, which is just going to go around it like this.
Okay.
And that's going to be very flavorful. The only other thing I'm going to add is some kosher salt over the top.
But we're not Jewish.
Yeah.
So what do you use kosher salt?
So kosher salt is very flavorful, and it is going to make quite a bit.
Is it because it's thicker?
It's grainier. I mean, I'm using this mill to bring it down to more soft variety of salt, but what I love about it is that it is extremely flavorful. It's going to mix in with the butter and the Provence herbs. This is what's going to go into my 500 degree oven, exactly like this, nothing else. Absolutely nothing else.
So we're coming back in how long?
We are coming back at about 6:30.
All right, 6:30.
6:30, and we will see if this method works.
Excellent. Bye-bye.
Mwah.
Au revoir. My funny Valentine by Ella. Yes, our Christmas tree is still up. Makes me want to light the candles. Have a scotch.
Hello, John.
And go to my beloved.
Ooh, hello, my love. So, we are 2 hours. Door closed, not opened. And we are taking out this prime standing rib of roast from International Meat Market. And we are...
Oh, Maron.
Ah, la mamma mia. And we are going to let that sit for a moment. Now that has been in a closed oven for 2 hours. However, we are going to now, because we need to finish our meal. We're going to go a little bit higher. We're going to finish our glacé carrots with raisins and Grand Marnier. Ooh!
Oh, wow.
Fingerling potatoes with fresh garlic and feta.
Oh, becoming Greek. All right.
And a little a beautiful au jus that started.
The au jus.
A little au jus, and we're going to...
Is the au jus preparatory? We can't really see what's in it.
That's correct. And we're going to add some of the drippings from this roast. We're going to slice it a tavola at the table.
A what?
A tavola at the table, and then we will continue from there.
Excellent. All right, bye. Love you. I love Billie Holiday. Sure says it very well for my beloved.
Hi, beloved. So we have a closed oven, standing rib roast that has sat in the oven for 2 hours with the door closed. Have you opened it, my love?
Opened it?
Did you open the door?
No.
No, you didn't, and neither did I. So we have a very unusual preparation of a standing rib roast from our beautiful International Meat Market in Astoria. We have some lovely fingerling potatoes with fresh roasted garlic and feta. We have some lovely julienne carote carrots. Yes. With raisins, and I'm going to add
some of the raisins are in some kind of liquor.
The raisins have been marinating in Grand Marnier, yes. And
she wants me drunk.
You have plans for me, don't you?
I always do.
Yeah.
We're going to add some beautiful, freshly grated nutmeg, which we just got in our neighborhood, in our hood, the other day.
Yo, baby, what's up? Yeah, I...
never thought that was gonna happen because I haven't been able to get this anywhere. So
that smells good.
Ooh, yeah.
Yeah.
And we are going to do a lovely au jus.
Now the au jus, and I know you said it was preparatory, but I know you put wine, something else, sherry, something else, this, something else, and then how you do it is something else.
We have a beautiful au jus, and it's going to be with red wine, white wine. It's going to have garlic. It's all been strained, and we're using all the drippings from the roast. And this is going to be a dense, dark, glorious au jus.
All I know is you had that cooking whatever.
Ooh.
I went to physical therapy, came back,